today?
I'm doing okay. Still adjusting to everything, but I don't know. It's been good. Kind of found a few things that keeps me entertained, so.
Well, that's good. What kind of things is that?
I've been reading a lot. I've always hated reading for some reason, and I would only want to read if I was, like, forced to. And now I've been really enjoying it, and we did this cooking thing for an activity one day, and I really like that, too. I don't know. It was, like, really relaxing. It took my mind off everything, so.
Well, that's great. You know, we have been talking about finding something for you to do in your spare time,
mm-hmm.
and it sounds like cooking is something that, you know, we should follow through with. Would you mind if I talked to the head of the kitchen about maybe taking, going in there, you know, a couple times a day or a couple times a week and helping her out with cooking some of the meals?
Yeah, that would be awesome. I would love that.
Okay. Then I will go ahead and make a note of that, and then after our session today, I'll go ahead and talk to her and see if, you know, if she can use some help. I'm sure she does. She's always looking for some help.
Okay.
All right. Well, I was wondering, have you talked to your dad since you've been here?
No. I'm really, kind of nervous about talking to him because I know he's just going to be so mad and disappointed, and I just feel like, I don't know. I thought about trying to call him one day, but I just don't really know if I should yet. I just feel like I really let him down, and it's just not going to really take it very easily, so.
Yeah, that's understandable. I do think it's important that you do at some point in time establish that connection back with him so that you guys can, you know, try to repair the relationship and get back to where you used to be.
Yeah.
You guys have had a tough past few years, you know. He lost his wife, you lost your mom, you lost his son, and you lost your brother.
Yeah.
You know, that's something that we should also take into consideration also, because, you know, you are each other's support system.
Yeah.
It sounds like that's all you guys have. So, you know, if you don't feel comfortable with talking to him right now, what if we wrote letters to him and, you know, started it that way? Would that be something that you are okay with?
Yeah. I mean, I would like to, like, write the letter. I just don't want to give it to him.
That's fine. You know, that makes sense because, you know, you guys really have been through a lot. What if we started it out this way, where you go ahead and, you know, write how you're feeling, like, with him, whether you were sorry or sad that you guys don't have a relationship, whatever you are feeling right now, write him a letter as if you were going to give it to him, but you don't have to give it to him. We can wait until you've worked through that. I do think that it would be important that we set a goal for at least the end of this week that you do, you know, let him know that you are doing okay in here. You know, it could be a short 5-second phone call, but I think that it would be important that he did hear from you.
Okay. I can try that, maybe. I just don't want to have to, like, talk to him. I'd just like to be, like, the conversation be like, hey, I just want to let you know that I'm making progress. And him be like, okay, love you. And I'd be like, love you too. I don't want him to be like, how are you feeling? Nothing. So I just, you know.
You know, would you prefer if I called him first?
Yeah, I think so.
We could let him know that you have, you know, less than a minute or something to, you know, to talk to him. But if you want, I can call him first and let him know, you know, that you do want to talk to him, but not for, like, a very long time, just a quick hello, goodbye.
Yeah, I think that would probably be better.
Okay, well, we can do that towards the end of the week. We can work in our next session about how to, you know, talk to him and get more comfortable with that. Why don't you go ahead and tell me about your relationship with your mom? You know, how was that? Were you guys close? Were you distant? Was it like a typical mom-daughter relationship?
No, actually we were really close. She was, like, seriously, like, my best friend. Like, I talk to her about everything. Like, when I was younger, she just always, like, knew everything. She wouldn't, I mean, sometimes she'd get mad about stuff, but she never, like, get mad to the point where she's always understanding about things and kind of like a friend would be. And, like, I remember when I was younger, like, in elementary school, everybody would go to each other's houses and hang out. Like, all my friends would want to come to my house because, like, they all just, like, love my mom, you know, and everybody else's mom was, like, they always considered been, like, mean, or, and my mom was just, like, the cool mom or the nice mom. I mean, she didn't let me just run wild or anything, but she was just a little bit more, like, she remembered what it was like to be young, and that's what I always loved about her.
She sounds like a really awesome lady. What about your brother? How is your guys' relationship? I know that you said he was much younger than you.
Yeah. Well, yeah, he was a lot younger, but I felt like I was, like, his kind of, like, mentor in a way. Like, I would always show him how, like, what to do and, like how to do different things. And as he got older, and, like, baseball, I always played softball, so I knew a lot about baseball. So when he started playing baseball, I was able to, like, go out and, like, show him different things. And so, as you know, we were really pretty far apart. I think it's about 10 years. We were also really close.
That's really good. So it sounds like, to me, that your family is, in general, a close-knit family.
Yeah, we are.
Since then, it's not really the same anymore. Is that something that you think that you would be willing to try and get back with your dad? Like, the closeness of the family, even though it's just you two?
Yeah, I would love to be close with my dad.
Okay.
Just because, I mean, he's basically all I have now. I mean, all my friends, I couldn't hang out with them if I wanted to because after I get out of here, because it would just be bad news. And I don't know, my dad's basically the only person I have that would be a good supporter and actually cares about me.
Well, you know, it sounds like you have all these different feelings that you were trying to work through, but you're very hesitant on, moving forward, with your dad.
Yeah.
I want to suggest, along with the letters, maybe doing some journaling. I think that you would benefit greatly from that. The reason I mention this is, I noticed that when we were talking about your mom, that it was a very hard topic for you to discuss. Mm-hmm. And I think that maybe after, we do have some hard conversations in our sessions, that you would benefit from writing about it afterwards. You don't necessarily have to write about it or, like, in detail. Like, it could be, like, one word, like, mad or frustrated or sad. Or
yeah,
you could talk about, like, what you did after the session, or, what we talked about in the session, different things like that. And they're just for you. You don't have to share them with me. You can if you want to. But I think that you doing this, once you get close to the time for you leaving, you can look back and see the progress that you have made. Because I think that's important for you.
Yeah. I think that would be good. Okay, I think I would. I mean, I've been enjoying reading a lot, so I think maybe writing
will make
I enjoy that a lot too. So,
okay, that's really good. Now, before we wrap things up, coming up, we have, I think in 3 weeks, we have a time where a parent can come in and sit in a counseling session if they want to.
Yeah.
Would that be something that you would want to do?
I don't know. I'll have to think about that one.
Okay. Yeah. We can, we can talk about that later. What about, have you given any more thought about the grief counseling?
I don't know. I feel like maybe I can start that in just, like, maybe, like, another week or two.
Okay.
Just, I
let me know and I can go ahead and, you know, schedule you on for that
okay.
for meeting. Is there anything else that you want to talk about today?
I don't think so.
Okay. Well, then how about I go ahead and schedule you for 3 days. And in the meantime, you go ahead and journal. Did they give you one, like a notebook or something when you first came?
I think so. I'll have to check in my room.
Okay. Well, if you can't find one, just let the staff on your floor know. They can go ahead and grab one out of the closet for you.
Okay.
All right. Well, then I'll see you in 3 days.
All right. Thank you.
I feel like...